The Gateway Arch looming over downtown St. Louis. The Brewers battle the Cardinals. Next. Good look at the nighttime skyline over St. Louis and Busch Stadium. Coming up, we've got a good matchup in store between the Milwaukee Brewers and the St. Louis Cardinals. Hi again, everybody. Matt Vaskirjian here for this NL Central Division matchup. I'm joined in the booth by longtime big leaguers Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. Before we get to them, let's have a look at the starting lineup for the visiting Milwaukee Brewers. Ron Renicki has his guys lined up like this. They'll have to match up against one of the very best around these past few seasons, the hard-throwing right-hander Adam Wainwright. And the Cardinals behind him will look like this defensively. Gene Segura makes his way to the plate now as we're just about set for baseball this evening. First pitch. Oh, look out! And a very interesting way to begin the ball game here tonight. Can't imagine guys like that too much.
Yeah, not too much indeed. You start getting into the danger area when it's up and in that high.
Now a swing and a bouncing ball toward the hole. Throw to first is in time for the first down. Chris Davis will stand in for the first time here. And this is fouled back and out of play. Here's a breaking ball outside, and now it's even one and one. One out, nobody on. One pitch is in the air now out to left field. Settling under it is Holiday to make the catch, and that's out number two.
And this is one of those guys that throws what you call a heavy sinker. Normally he's going to get a lot of ground balls, but he leaves this one up in the zone. And I think he's lucky that this ball didn't get hit farther than it did.
Ryan Braun will have his first opportunity now as it comes with the bases empty here in the top of the first. Breaking ball for a strike, 0-1.
I think if you gave him another chance, he'd be swinging at that one. That was a great pitch to hit.
Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. And the cutter got him swinging. Strike three, and the side is retired. Gone in order are the Brewers. Now the Cardinals will see what they can do. No score. Now the starting lineup for the Cardinals looks like this. They'll match up against an ace and a workhorse all wrapped into one, the all-star right-hander Yovani Gallardo. And there you see a look at the defensive alignment behind him for the Brewers. Matt Carpenter will step in now to lead things off in the home half of the first. He'll start him with a breaking ball. Too low that time. It's ball one. Carpenter, a real breakout performer for the National League champs last year, as he in fact led the circuit in runs, hits, and doubles. And this is in the air down the left field line and into foul territory, and no one will track it down. Ready now on 1-1. And this is lined into left field for their first hit of the ball game.
Well, that curveball is going to be an important pitch for him to locate going forward. This one's not terrible, but it is over the plate. It gets turned into a leadoff single.
Johnny Peralta will stand in now. He'll likely have a look down to third to see if anything's up here with nobody out. In there for strike one, 0-1. A runner at first with no outs here. There he goes. Pitch outside, the throw. Ball's there and he is out trying to take second. Good throw.
Well, you know, so much for that first hit of the game. Now he's going to try to press his luck and take second, but a good throw cuts him down.
Come on, Cardinal.
Hands held high by Peralta. Now the pitch. Lined hard to center field. Gomez is there, two gone.
The minute he hits that, he's thinking it's a base hit all the way, but it's one of those situations where, you know, you get penalized for hitting the ball too hard. And this stayed up long enough to find the outfielder's glove out there.
Matt Holliday will get his first cuts now, and he'll do so with the bases empty and two away here in the first. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. Holiday last year, another typical Matt Holiday season, an even 300 average, 22 home runs and 94 driven in. And that misses, 2-0.
Two really close pitches to kick off this at bat. Normally this guy would be all over him, but he's shown some discipline here with two good takes.
And this is a called strike at the letters. Looked like ball three, but make it 2-1 instead. Donnie couldn't pull that one back as he clearly broke the plane of the plate, and that'll be ruled a strike. And he just does manage to fight this one off as it's fouled away. Another 2-2 offering. Swing and a high chopper to third. Aramis has it. throw in time, and the side is retired. Redbirds down quietly. We played an inning. No score. Aramis Ramirez leads things off now in the top half of the second.
Leading up for Milwaukee, third baseman, Aramis Ramirez.
A called strike to the 35-year-old veteran. Nothing in one. And he just gets a piece there as this is chopped foul. Now a ball hit hard towards the hole. And he'll turn and fire a desperation throw to first. And a heck of an effort that time, but the throw's too late, and that'll certainly be scored an infield single to lead off the inning.
Well, this would have taken a superhuman effort right here. Deep in the hole, you see he doesn't have time to plant himself, so he just leaps into the air, fires it across the diamond. Just a great effort, but this was always going to be a base hit.
Carlos Gomez will dig in here. And Wainwright opens with a changeup, good for strike one.
And he's probably not going to throw too many first pitch changeups. That's a pretty darn good call.
On at first is Ramirez with nobody out. That's over, but low, it's a ball and a strike. Out in front here as this is pulled down the third baseline. And this is past him at third, down the line. It's a fair ball. And the runner holds at second, so they're at first and second now with nobody out.
Can't ask for a whole lot more to start the inning. Hey, back-to-back base hits have them threatened to score our first run of the night.
Jonathan Lucroy digs in at the plate. Now here's the first pitch, and he hits the bottom of the strike zone here with the sinker, strike one.
Now with two on, nobody out, you got to be thinking strikeout double play out there on the mound. One or the other is what you really need.
And this is swung on and bounced on the ground to third. To second for one, and the return throw sailed a bit, but good agility at first to go up, snare it, and then come down with his foot on the bag, and it's a double play.
First baseman.
Oh, this will be a good look here in show motion. Even in super slow-mo, I think we all know what's running through his mind right here. He knows he's going to get leveled, and this is something right out of a gymnastics class. That one had to hurt.
Juan Francisco will get his first shot here, trying to come through with two away and a runner at third. First pitch here is a sinker that runs a bit too wide. It's ball one.
And even after the double play, you can still make something out of this inning with a simple base hit here.
Now a hard hit ball back up the middle. And that's going to be a base hit, and the Brew Crew has struck first here. It's now 1-0.
Yeah, that's a good job right there with two away to pick up the first run of the ball game from third base. Very important to cash in when you're given the early opportunities, and he comes through big time right there.
Scooter Jeanette. We'll try and keep things going now with a runner at first following the RBI single. First pitch coming from Wainwright. Grounded, foul.
Foul ball. Get him.
Oh, and you talk about a pitcher getting the benefit of the doubt. That's low, but called a strike anyway. Nothing in two now.
Whether you like it or not, now that you've seen what the strike zone's going to be like, you're going to have to make an adjustment.
Swinging a ball hit on the ground, but this will be a foul ball, and it's still 0-2. Another 0-2 now from Wainwright. Now here's a ball hit hard on the ground towards short, and an underhanded throw is in time for out number three. So one run on three hits, no errors, and one man left on. On now to the bottom of the second. Brewers lead it 1-0. Alan Craig will start things off in the bottom of the second. And this one's not close. It's in the dirt for ball one.
Yeah, those are the ones you like to start in at bat, especially your first time up.
I agree. Give me a nice easy one in the dirt that I can take so I can really get ahead in that count early.
Two and oh now.
Two times here they've gone away. Both pretty easy takes. And as a hitter, now I'm thinking it might be time they try to bust something inside.
Line hard into left, but he'll hardly need to move out there in left as this is hauled in for the first out.
Well, in this at-bat, he did everything right. He got himself into a good hitter's count. That's 2-0. Found a good pitch to hit, and he hit it hard. Just unlucky, I guess. He hit it right at somebody.
Matt Adams will stand in. First pitch on its way from Gallardo. And this ball's going to find the seats down the left field line. Foul, strike one. And oh, you talk about getting a pitcher's call. There's one there, and it's 0-2.
I think generous is the word here. That looked like it was 6 inches off the plate.
And he missed with it. It's 1-2.
Could be that that high fastball there was just a setup pitch. Now you've kind of established that high sight level. Could be a good time to break off a nasty curveball.
To two balls and two strikes now.
He's hoping to just run that heater by him. So he's ramped up the velocity here the last two pitches.
Trying to nibble here, and he misses to run it full now. 3-2.
So many times pitchers will get ahead, then they'll start to mess around, and the next thing you know, it's a full count like it is here.
Come on, let's get a hit.
And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four.
That's a real good at bat there. He fell behind 1-2 right out of the gate, but instead of going out of the zone to protect, he was able to lay off three straight, get his guys a leadoff base runner.
Yadier Molina will get his first shot here with the runner at first now and one away. Hey, There's a good fastball on the outside corner as he'll take a look at strike one.
A high fastball that time in the strike zone and on the outside corner. But that is a dangerous spot to be pitching if you're only throwing in the low 90s.
Runners going. Pitch is a called strike. The throw. And he got him at second on a perfect throw.
Well, and any designs they might have had about doing a lot of running tonight may need to be 86 right now because it's just not happening for him out there.
Bases are empty here with two men out. Swing and a hard liner to center field. Gomez is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. Nothing doing there for St. Louis. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. Giovanni Gallardo will turn right around and get us started here. 9-1-2 to start inning number three. Back on the hill is Wainwright now as he jumps ahead of the leadoff man, nothing and one. And boy, big problems here to start this at bat. It's 0-2 now.
And it wouldn't be the worst thing in the world here to mix in a take every now and again.
And this is heading out toward left field, but this is going to get fouled up into the crowd. Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning.
Well, always nice to get the inning started against the pitcher, and he sets him down easily for the first out of the third.
Gene Segura will get a second shot now. He grounded out to start the ball game. And he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away. And this is going to be a foul ball. And this one's hit on the ground, but foul. Way outside. 1-2.
Well, he's had a lot of guys swinging at pitches out of the strike zone early on, so it's a great idea to go ahead and bounce one there on 0-2.
And this is a strike three called. Oh, caught a break there. Two away.
Yeah, I think it's fair to say he didn't care too much for that call at the plate. But was he right? Showtrack says... Yeah, I think he's got a little bit of a beef up there. That pitch looked to be a good few inches off the plate, and that's a tough way to go down. You know, no hitter likes to have the bat taken out of his hands.
Chris Davis stands in as he looks at ball one here.
And even with two outs, this is a team that can still put something together here, especially in this part of the lineup. So you can't let your guard down.
Swing and he takes this the other way to right. Craig is under it and he makes the catch for out number three. A scoreless half inning there from Adam Wainwright. His club trails 1-0. John Jay makes his way to the plate to get us started here in the bottom of inning number three. First offering on the way. Now a fastball a bit too low here. It's ball one. That ball's headed for the gap in left center. He's got a base hit, possibly more. And now he has some trouble with it in center. And he will coast into second with a leadoff double.
That's a great swing there. Leading off an inning, it's a fastball, but he just goes right with it and drives it the other way toward the gap. He's going to wind up on second here with a leadoff double.
Colton Wong will get his first shot at it here. And he lays off there 1-0.
Obviously, you want a base hit here and hopefully tie this game. But a ground ball to the right side, that wouldn't be so bad either.
A runner at second, nobody out.
Here we go, guys.
Short lead from second, now the pitch. Fastball misses badly there, and he's behind 2-0. He'll lay the fastball in here to get the count back to 2-1. And he's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Well, if he's missing right here, he ain't missing by much. Not getting too many favors behind the plate.
No one out with a runner at second. And that one is a called strike as he's rebounded to run it full now, 3-2. Now a ground ball left side and through into left to base hit. He'll come home with it. And the run will score from second as this ball game is tied one apiece. Adam Wainwright will stand in what would appear to be a sacrifice situation here. Infield expecting bunt. Here's the first pitch. And now Wainwright squares around and gets the bunt down. Only plays to first, so the pitcher does his job as it's a successful sacrifice.
And that's exactly what you want out of your pitcher. No long at bat. Get in, get it down, and get out of there. And on one pitch, he's able to get the job done.
Matt Carpenter will stand in. He singled to lead off the home first. Now a swing and a ground ball on to first, and there are two down. Man at second here with two away, and that'll bring up the shortstop, Johnny Peralta. Pretty well hit, deep down the line in right, but that's back into the seats, foul. Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame. Keeping him close there at second. Now the pitch. In there at the knees, 0-2 now.
And now 0-2 here. This is where you need to expand the zone. If it's close, you got to let it fly.
Slider, and it's off his glove, and it bounces away. And he'll make it to third here on what will likely be ruled a passed ball.
Fortunately, that's probably not the worst thing that could have happened. You figure he would have scored on a base hit from second base and two outs anyway, but it's a passed ball nonetheless.
On the ground, softly towards second. And indeed, he'll take only the out at first as the run comes in to score. I have to imagine there's a full moon tonight, judging by this bunch. We're back at Busch Stadium right after this. Back with Eric Harris and Steve Lyons, Matt Vaskirjian, as Ryan Braun steps forward to get things started here in the Milwaukee half of the inning. And that one's in on the hands to start the inning. It's ball one.
And if he can get himself into a fastball count, don't be surprised if he has a big cut at something. Maybe try and break this tie ball game.
Braun awaiting the 1-0. And that's right there, and we're even at one.
Boy, his control has been outstanding so far. And there's another pitch right on the block.
Here's a hard hit ball back up the middle. And the off-balance throw beats him at first, and that's a tough play. So with that, let's call on the guys in the graphics department to put up the pitch speed comparison for the two starters. And both of these guys are working right around the same speed, 93 for one, 92 for the other. Aramis Ramirez will stride in again. He singled and later scored his first time. Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground to short. He's got it. On to first, and a good stretch over there is going to get him by a step for the second out.
And this is a high degree of difficulty play out there at short. You know, it's one thing if this ball's hit up the middle, but this ball's taking him away from first base towards the hole. But he's still able to get back to his feet and strong arm it over there to first to get his man.
So bases are empty here with two gone, and standing in the speedy Carlos Gomez. Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one. Good hard sinker that time, and he's in control, 0-2.
And he's really going to have to fight now. You got to take a little bit out of your swing and find a way to put this ball in play.
Tried to get him to go after one below the knees, but it's 1-2. And the cutter got him swinging. Strike three, and the side is retired. Three up, three down for Milwaukee. On to the bottom of the fourth, tied 1-1. Matt Holliday will lead things off here in the home half of the fourth.
Left fielder, Matt Holliday.
First pitch on its way from Gallardo. Down and away, one ball and no strikes. And a fastball here that's taken for ball two.
Yeah, he's looked at two close pitches. You get the feeling that this is the calm before the storm. I think he'll unload on this one if this thing is anywhere near the zone.
Let's do it, Cardinals!
2-0 on the way. Too high, and it's 3-0.
Not the best of starts to this fourth inning.
Ruled a strike on the outside corner, 3-1. No leadoff walk just yet as that finds the strike zone and the count comes full at 3-2.
Well, that may have been the last pitch in the at-bat that he could do something with. He's not going to get anything better than that.
And that misses for ball four. The leadoff walk that starts at the bottom of the fourth.
Hey, you know what? That's all right. He gave him a pretty good battle up there and he never gave in to him. A walk you can work around. A home run, you can't.
Alan Craig will stand in, a lineout victim his first time. Fouled back.
Let's go, guys. Come on.
A lot of movement that time. It's 0-2.
And you know what, guys? I have been really impressed so far. Not only has he used his fastball well, but he's also spotted it well. I mean, that is perfect location, right on the knees.
And this one's in the dirt.
Look out, watch your head.
The throw pulls him off the bag.
Not exactly the finest of starts to the inning out there on the mound. A walk followed by a wild pitch. This is a good time to go out there and say, hey, what's up?
Okay, big opportunity, guys.
And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2.
And when he's down 0-2, he's smart enough to know guys are going to try and get him to chase. So now at 2-2, he's got himself back to a spot where he doesn't have to go after a pitcher's pitch.
And this misses, so that'll fill the count at 3-2.
You can just sense him starting to tense up out there on the mound. They had him down 0-2, and now he's struggling to make the perfect pitch, and it's not happening.
Swing and a ball hit foul as this will find the seats in right. Holiday off a second, now the pitch. Now a ball softly hit out to short. And they've got a man caught in the rundown. And he is out, retreating to second as they slap the tag on him.
Yeah, not a real heady base running move right there. He's got thoughts of going to third, and then he thinks better of it. And by then, he's a dead duck out there trying to make it back to second.
Matt Adams will stand in. He drew base on balls his first time. And a fastball close, but ultimately ruled a ball, 1-0.
And if you're wondering, that's 52 pitches now through 3 1/3.
Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one.
Yeah, they're being really careful with this guy. Remember, they walked him the first time around, and now they're behind 2-0 to him right here.
Now here's one hit in the air to the right side, but this is back into the seats, a foul ball. Runner on first here with one gone and a 1-1 tie. And that swung on and fouled straight back. Changes up on him, but that's in the dirt for a ball.
Now the question, do you send the guy on 3-2 with one out? You figure you're going to get something around the plate.
Misses with that one for ball four. So that'll put runners on first and second now with one away.
Second walk here in the fourth inning. I mean, that's too many against his punch. It doesn't look like he and his catcher are on the same page right now.
So two men are on with one man out. And here now is the catcher, Yadier Molina. And that misses ball one.
Yeah, he didn't seem to do him any favors with the previous batter, and now here's another call that goes against him on the mound.
Runners are at first and second with one away. Pickoff move to second, but the runner's back easily. Turn and throw back to second again. Might have an idea something's up here. And a double steal try here. Here's a bouncing ball now headed for the shortstop, Segura. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. A couple of walks, but no damage. More ahead from St. Louis right after this. Jonathan Lucroy will make his way towards the box to lead off the fifth.
Catcher, Jonathan Lucroy.
First pitch coming from Wainwright. First pitch of the inning is taken downstairs for a ball. It's 1-0. The pitch count there, one pitch into his fifth inning of work. Not much of a concern, I wouldn't imagine.
Yeah, it shouldn't be. He hasn't had any real overtaxed inning, so he should be fine for the time being.
Chop foul right by home plate, and it's a ball and a strike. Wainwright ready, the 1-1. And this ball will be chopped foul. And this is fought off at the plate as it's chopped foul. Now a ball hit hard towards center. And a dive by Peralta, but Johnny comes up empty. It's a base hit.
Yeah, that's a good job right there of reaching base to kick off the inning. He'd retired six in a row prior to that, so they finally have a base runner here for the first time in a couple innings.
Juan Francisco will stand in, an RBI single in his first appearance. And they start him out away with a cold strike.
And EK, I don't know about you, but I really hated getting a bad call on that very first pitch.
Hey, jeez, it puts you just in a terrible frame of mind.
Well hit high in the air and deep to center field. There to take it is Jay, and he's got it for the first out.
That ball was hit well, and it might have been a different story if he pulled it. Instead, he hit it to the big part of the ballpark, and he's retired.
Scooter Jeanette will dig in. 0 for 1 here in this one. Here's the first pitch to him. And a first pitch sinker is over for strike one.
He's just cruising out there now. I'll tell you, this may turn into a game of first team to two wins.
outside for a ball, 1-1. And there's ball two now. A little too tall that time. 3-1 now.
And he's got a little bit of work to do now to avoid that first walk.
One run, four hits, and no errors on the Milwaukee line score so far. Here's one hit back over the mound near second. And that'll get by into center field for a base hit. The relay throw, and he'll make it over to third base safely, so that puts runners at the corners with only one gone.
Well, the good ones make it look easy, don't they? I mean, if you're hitting 230, this ball doesn't drop for a hit. No way. But he'll tell you, that's just the way I had it planned.
Giovanni Gallardo will stand in for the second time as he watches one miss low. It's a ball and no strikes. You got to say, for a strikeout pitcher, not too many strikeouts here so far.
And he's in a big need of one right here. It would definitely come in handy.
And this one's a bit higher as that's in there at the knees for the first strike.
Even though he swung through that one, you can start to see that the swings are getting a little better here in this fifth inning.
Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1.
And one thing you can't do here, you cannot lose him and load the bases. He's still got a couple pitches to play with, but I'd expect this one to be somewhere in the strike zone.
Here comes the 2-1. Oh, and now look at this. The pitcher gives one a ride to deep left. And this ball is gone. So a three-run blast to straightaway left, and the Brewers have moved to a 4-1 lead.
You can tell he was making a concerted effort to keep the ball down against this guy, but you just can't keep it down forever, and he finally got a pitch he could handle.
Gene Segura will try it again. He's grounded out and struck out in two trips.
Let's go, Redbird.
Third baseman in tight, protecting the bunt, the first pitch. Swing and a ball chop foul down the left side. Couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Off the plate and in, it's a ball and a strike. Seems like whatever was working early on suddenly is not working now.
It's almost like he's imploding right before our eyes.
Look into Molina, now the 1-1. And a sinker dips too low there. Into the dirt, in fact.
And you kind of get the sense that his head isn't in it right now. You got to put all your concentration into that hitter. You can leave worrying about the pass for your film session tomorrow.
2-1 pitch is a cut fastball taken for strike two. Three runs already home here. And he takes ball three, so it's a full count now. Chris Davis waits on deck. And he looks at ball four now, so he's aboard, and you always have to worry about the threat of the steal when he's on base.
Well, when you're already in a deep hole, the last thing you want to do is keep digging. But the walk here is only going to make things worse.
Chris Davis will take another shot here. He's flied out and lined out in two trips.
Watch for movement.
Out of play. Off the plate, one ball, one strike. Wait. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. Four runs, six hits, and no errors on the Milwaukee line score so far. Comes back with the cut fastball for strike three called, and there are two down. Ryan Braun will dig in for the third time now. He's struck out and bounced out in his first two trips. Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one.
And even with three runs in here, that guy's still a threat to go at first. He may try and make this inning worse.
Hit hard on the ground is short. Throw on to second for the force, and the side is retired. But three in the inning for the Brewers on the strength of this three-run home run. Middle of the night here at Busch Stadium. It's now 4-1 Milwaukee. John Jay will stand in to start things out here in the home half of the fifth. And you get the sense, Steve, that this crowd's been pretty well taken out of the ballgame to this point.
Yeah, they pretty much had to sit on their hands all afternoon. Not a lot to get excited about so far. And I think that's a credit to that man out there on the mound. He's cut right through this lineup for the first four innings.
Here we go.
And that's inside for a ball, 1-0. Up around the letters with that one for ball two.
And after that double in his first at bat, you can tell they're approaching him with a bit more caution here. As well they should.
The 2-0. And here's a fastball that swung on and lifted down the left field line. Davis moves over near the line as he puts it away for the first out of the inning.
Well, you know, he had the right idea up there, so at least you know he's thinking. He tried to go the other way with this ball, but he got under it just a little bit, and it's an easy play out there in left field.
Colton Wong will stand in, an RBI single in his first appearance. And this one's nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball one. Couldn't get his hands through there, and it's 1-1. Seems like we've seen a lot of guys late on the fastball tonight.
And he's not throwing all that hard either, but when he throws it off the other pitches, that's where it makes it a little more difficult.
And a slider runs in on him as he has to lean out of the way.
Yeah, he's not trying to hit him, I don't think, but sometimes you need to keep guys honest up there. I think that's all he was trying to do there.
Here's Gallardo now with the 2-1. And, ooh, he's really given some leeway on the outside edge here, 2-2 now.
And maybe that's off the black just a little bit, but when you're around the plate as much as he's been, you're going to find that you're going to get a few calls like that.
And this is fouled back and out of play. fifth inning here in a 4-1 ball game. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2. Now the pitch.
Here we go.
Grounded, foul. And he finally wins the battle as this is swung on and missed for the second out.
And so far he's been real effective using that inside part of the plate tonight. I don't think that pitch was even in the strike zone, and Showtrack will confirm that for us right now. But I guess he felt like it was close enough that he had to take a rip at it.
Peter Borges is out of the dugout now, as it looks like he'll come on and hit for the pitcher, Wainwright. Hard hit towards center. Gomez is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. He won't bat with runners on, but the powerful Aramis Ramirez will lead things off regardless when we come back. It's the Brewers 4. Seth Maness will get the call here as he'll start the sixth inning on the mound. And there is Aramis Ramirez now. He'll do battle with a new arm out there in their half of the sixth.
Aramis Ramirez.
And a fastball taken the other way, but this should be routine out there in right field. Therefore, it is Craig, and he'll put it away for the first out. Carlos Gomez will stand in now. He's singled and struck out in two trips. And now the Cardinals get the bullpen working here. Both a lefty and a right-hander have stood up. There's a fastball missing down and away for a ball, 1-0. Sixth inning, 4-1 is our score. And this is hit hard on the ground towards short. Look at the stop! But the throw will be well late. So a good play, but it's all for naught, as that'll be an infield single.
Well, this was a heck of an effort to get to this thing. What a stop! But the way this guy can run, no chance to get him at first. That's an infield hit.
Jonathan Lucroy will dig in, 1-for-2 to this point in the ball game. And he catches the inside corner for a called strike. Hit hard to the right side. Foul. And this is hit hard to the right side. And that'll slice just foul at the last moment. Stays alive here as this is fouled off to the right. That's inside and low. It's a ball and two strikes. From the belt, the pitch. 1-2 is an off-speed pitch. No dice, it's 2-2.
Yeah, an interesting setup now on 2-2. Here's where you really need to pay attention to that guy at first.
A swing as he shoots this one over to the right side, and that'll find the big hole over there. It's a base hit. And they'll get it in quickly, so it's runners at first and second now with one man out.
Well, he got that first out easy enough when he came on, but now it's back-to-back hits here with one away. So he's going to have to bear down now and make sure that this thing doesn't get any worse.
Juan Francisco will dig in now. A single and a flyout for him in two trips thus far. And that's dead center for strike one. Close to the bag at second there. Now the pitch. Swing and a ball headed towards the hole. Oh, and this goes right past him. The throw to the plate. And on the error, a run is going to score.
When you're already losing, the one thing you can't do is give away more runs. I mean, you're already in the hole. The last thing you want to do is keep digging, but that's what's happening right here. Things are going from bad to worse now.
Scooter Gennett will dig in. He singled and later scored his last time. And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1.
And you know, down there at third base, he absolutely wants another shot at a ground ball. Something to try and make up for that error.
On a big swing as he takes this one to the opposite field. High and deep to left center. Around third and being waved on home. And he will score as well as they've broken this one wide open now as the lead swells to six.
Yeah, he squared that one up pretty good. No chance to run this one down as you see it one hop the wall out there. And he'll ease his way into second with a two-run double.
Giovanni Gallardo. Get a shot now in an RBI spot, so a chance to help his own cause here.
And he's got a hit in the game already, so he can handle the bat at least a little bit.
And he makes good contact there, but this is going to find the stands foul down the right field line. Good changeup, and it's 0-2.
And this is what he needs out there right now. He has to find some confidence in those secondary pitches, and that's a good changeup there.
Runner at second here with one man out. Here's one hit towards the hole. And that's through into right field for a base hit. And they won't risk it at third, so they're at the corners now with only one away.
Boy, he's doing it all out there so far. Not only is he pitching a great game, but he gets in on the act offensively as well.
Gene Segura. We'll step in now with three home in the inning and another two men out there on base.
This inning's really starting to unravel quickly from a defensive point of view. This is where you need a nice pop-up in a big way.
And he hits the bottom of the strike zone here with the sinker. Strike one. Seems like they're showing a lot of faith in this guy, leaving him out there.
And I think you appreciate that as a pitcher, but sometimes when you don't have it, you don't have it. Looks like this is going to be one of those times.
Runners lead from first and third. Here's the pitch. Here's a swing and a ground ball. Peralta for one. On to first, but not in time. He beats it out to keep the inning alive, and the run is in to score.
Oh, and he nearly got that double play he needed to get himself out of the inning. But you see the good hard slide here at second base and the return throw just a little too late. So that'll be scored a fielder's choice and an RBI.
Chris Davis will stand in, one of the few guys not to join the hit parade so far.
Water. Get your water here.
Here's a line drive caught coming off the bag. Needed just a little more height on that one, but instead the inning is over. So they nearly bat around here as eight men come to the plate and they push across four runs. Top of the order due up in the home. Matt Carpenter will stand in to start things off as this top of the batting order hasn't found a whole lot of success so far.
In fact, just one hit between the 1-2-3 hitters combined. So apparently the table setters have not been getting their chores done.
On Gallardo with the good live fastball. It's 0-1. That's over, but low. It's a ball and a strike. And this is hit sharply toward the third base coaching box, a foul ball. The 1-2 coming from Gallardo. Look out, that one almost got away from him. 2-2 now. Under the 2-2 a bit as this is sent in the air out to straightaway central, and this will be taken in out there by Gomez for the first out.
You know, I don't have the numbers in front of me right now, but I can guarantee you, you give this guy a 7-run lead, he ain't coughing it up. This is going to be a long road back, that's for sure.
Johnny Peralta will step in. He's lined out and grounded out in two trips. Now a pitch swung on and hit to the left side, but this is going to find the seats, a foul ball. That misses to the Cardinal shortstop, and it's even at 1-1. And here's a ball hit in the air. Under it, Jeanette, and there are two away now.
Yeah, that's not too tough a play right there because he's already playing deep at second base anyway. So he just ranges out into the outfield and he makes the play.
Matt Holliday will stand in. Base on balls his last time. First pitch coming. Fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0.
And that man right there, he's got to figure out some kind of combination to score some runs for him. They have really been scuffling.
Up top, it's 2-0.
Well, one thing we've seen from this guy on the mound so far, when he makes bad pitches, they typically miss out of the strike zone. They don't miss in the zone where they can be crushed.
3-0 now.
And this is where a guy who's been around a long time knows, hey, we're not going to make up the difference with just one swing. It's going to take base runners. So that's a good job of being really patient at the plate.
Two out, nobody on. And this is popped fouled off to the right and back into the seats. And there's a fastball that's hammered the other way to deep right field. And that'll get down for what should be extra bases. And he is in the second with a two-out double.
Well, this is just a nice job of hitting at the plate. This pitch looked to be off the outer edge, but you can see him sort of dive out over the plate to go get it, and he winds up driving this ball for two bases.
Alan Craig will get an opportunity here in a run-scoring spot now following the two-out double. One. Not the first time he's felt the squeeze tonight.
Yeah, he's looking and saying, what do I got to do to get a strike?
Now here's a swing and a ball hit well out there toward right center. And a dive, but he can't pull it in out in right center. And he will pull into second with an RBI double. Matt Adams will stand in. Base on balls his last time. And that misses for ball one.
And you know, he's been the beneficiary of most of the calls here tonight, but I think that's one that he thought he should have had.
No lead to speak of at second. Here's the pitch. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
Well, it's pretty obvious to me right here. First base is open following that double. I don't think they have any intention of giving him anything in the strike zone.
Nope. 3-0. Green light here on 3-0.
Yeah, I want my run producer swinging the bat. It's my number 7 hitter? Probably not.
And he takes ball four again. And clearly, guys, they just don't want any part of him in this one. Yadier Molina will step in now and see what he can do with two on and two out here in the sixth. Now some movement out in the Milwaukee bullpen. Both a lefty and a right-hander have begun to stretch it out. Gets under this one as this is hit high and pretty deep out there to center field. Gomez retreats to the track, and he'll put this one away. So a sigh of relief as the side is retired. One for the Cardinals on this swing by Alan Craig. Heart of the order, 3-4-5 coming up to start the seventh. It's the Brewers 8 and the Cardinals 2. Welcome back to Busch Stadium here in St. Louis. We're on to the seventh now with the Brewers out on top. If you're joining us late, good time to get caught up as there's our game summary to this point. Randy Choate will come on now in a mop-up role as he'll just try and keep this deficit from growing any larger. Ryan Braun will stand in, and they've been able to hold him in check so far. 0-for-3 to this point.
Yeah, it's kind of surprising that he's been a non-factor in this one, usually a major force in their offense.
Overrated. Pitch to the plate is a sinker for a called strike one. Big swing there by Braun, but he comes up empty. No balls and two strikes.
They haven't been afraid of coming right after this guy. They've made him have to swing the bat.
strikeout here.
Got him on a good slider there. Swung on and missed as he's down on strikes for the second time tonight.
And he may be considered to be a left-handed specialist, but he can get right-handed hitters out. He shows it to you right there.
Aramis Ramirez will stand in. He flew out his last time up. And now here's a ball lifted out to center for Jay. Two gone.
And at this point in the game, your defenders will love you for this. He's been able to pick up the first two outs of the inning here on just four pitches.
Carlos Gomez will step in. Singled and came around to score his last time. Start him out with a slider. Good spot, but he doesn't get the call. 1-0. Looks at a sinker there that drops in. 1-1. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. And, oh, he's really given some leeway on the outside edge here. 2-2 now. And a slider called strike three as he couldn't pull the trigger and the side is retired. Gone in order are the Brewers, but no matter, they lead it 8-2. John Jay will step in now to lead off the home half of the seventh.
Center fielder, John Jay.
Fastball too high to start him out here, 1-0. Well, the guy you see right there calling the shots has opted to roll with his starter here to begin his half of the seventh.
And that pitch count is a concern, so he may get the chance to finish this inning off and then call it a night.
Here's a 1-0.
Here we go.
Fouled back. Swing and a miss on a pitch outside. 1-2 now.
Well, nothing fancy. Three fastballs so far in this at bat. He could go just about anywhere from here.
To two balls and two strikes now. Now a pitch on the way. Here's one that misses inside and the count's run full now, 3-2.
Keep in mind now, the longer this at bat goes, the higher the likelihood that this becomes his last inning out there.
And a tough pitch on two strikes as he's able to foul it off. Boy, really making him work now as the seventh pitch of the at-bat is also fouled away, so the count will hold steady at 3 balls and 2 strikes. And he can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an 8-pitch at-bat.
When you got a guy out there that made 30-plus starts last year, you don't worry too much about his pitch count, but he's creeping up there toward that century mark.
Colton Wong will try again, struck out swinging his last time through. Fastball off the plate away. It's ball one.
That last pitch puts him at 100, so that probably makes this his last inning, even if he makes it all the way through.
And he'll try to hold back the swing, but he'll do so unsuccessfully as that's ruled a strike. Bases are empty, one man out. Swinging a ball line down in the left field corner, but this will be foul. Misses, ball two. Here it comes. 3-2 now.
Just like the guy he faced before this, another long at bat here. He's had to make 13 pitches just to these last two hitters.
And this is going to be a foul ball. Out in front as he pulls this one down the line at first. And he'll take this to the bag himself, and there are two away now.
Now batting.
Tony Cruz will get the call to pinch hit here as we'll see what he can do with two out and the bases empty. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Fastball in there for a called strike. Well, that pitch isn't going to light up the radar gun, but it's been effective.
Well, it doesn't have to. If you get that good movement and put it in the right spot, it's plenty good enough to do the job.
Now a swing here and another ground ball headed to first. And he'll step on the bag himself and the inning is over. So a great half inning of work by Giovanni Gallardo. His club leads it big. Kevin Segrist will come on now in a mop-up role as he'll just try and keep this deficit from growing any larger. Jonathan Lucroy will get us going now in the top half of the eighth. First pitch fastball swung on and missed 0-1.
Well, he'll lean pretty heavily on that fastball. Why not? Yeah. It's a big one.
And he takes this one high, 1-1. Up high, 2-1 now. Good spot for the change there, and that'll knock things up at 2-2.
Wow, what a good time to take something off of that pitch, and they had him fooled pretty good on that one.
Woo! And here's a curveball that's laid off that time. It's full, 3-2. One thing that man right there will not tolerate, leadoff walks.
Especially right out of the bullpen. This might be a quick outing if that happens.
This is swung on and grounded out to the shortstop, Peralta. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number 8. And look there at the starter comparison, telling the story of the ballgame. One guy still going and pitching well. The other one long since departed for the showers. Juan Francisco will be the batter. He reached on an error and later scored his last time. Lefty versus lefty, and the first pitch misses for ball one.
Let's go! Shut him down!
I got the high fastball there, and he popped it straight up, way up there on the infield. And Peralta will put this one away for out number 2. Moving closer towards our conclusion now. 8-2 the count in this one, as our line score will give you a look at how we got to this point in the contest. Scooter Gennett will step in. He doubled home a couple this last time. Now a swing and a fly ball. Craig is there, makes the catch, and the side is retired. 3 up, 3 down for Milwaukee. But no matter, they lead it 8-2. Well, there you see Brewer manager Ron Renicke out for a conference at home plate, so I would imagine we're going to see a double switch here. Brandon Kinsler will come in now, working with a huge lead, so he'll just look to get some work in here.
Number 53, Brandon Kinsler, now playing first base and batting in the ninth spot. Number 7,
Matt Carpenter will lead things off here in the bottom half of inning number 8.
Leading off for St. Louis, third baseman Matt Carpenter.
And a check swing here, but he clearly went around on a pitch that would have been a strike anyway. It's nothing and one. Strike 2. Here's a ball lined up and over the head of Segura. It's short. It's on into left center for a base hit.
Well, these guys have been high on effort but low on results so far. They're still stuck on 2 runs, but at least they've got a leadoff base runner here to start this inning.
Johnny Peralta will stand in. He flew out his last time up. Big hole on the right side. Here's the first pitch. And this will be fouled away. And a good spot for that pitch is it's chopped foul. I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away.
Avoid the deuce.
Fastball called, strike 3, and there's the first out of the inning.
You don't need to be a lip reader or an expert in body language to know that he was not thrilled with that call. You know, just about every umpire has a different interpretation of what a high strike should be. But none of them like it when guys carry on like this. Gotta be careful.
Matt Holliday will step in, 1-for-2 in the ballgame. Now the first pitch. Here's a slider to start things out, looked at for ball one. And that catches the outside edge, 1-1.
Yeah, the best way to neutralize this guy's power, just keep putting pitches right there.
And a liner foul into the seats down the right side. Here comes the 1-2. And this is on the ground toward the hole. To second for one. On to Reynolds, and they turn it, a double play. Side retired. Around the horn they go. 5-4-3 to end the threat. We're back at Busch Stadium right after this. Mark Reynolds will get us started as they look for a little insurance here in the top of the ninth.
First baseman, Mark Reynolds.
Here we go with inning number 9 as the first pitch misses for ball one. Swung on and fouled straight back. And this is low, ball two, 2-1. Now here's the pitch. Could have been 3-1. Instead, it's 2-2.
This fastball is looking pretty lively right now.
And a pitch swung on and bounced to Peralta at short. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway. Gene Segura will stand in. He grounded into a fielder's choice his last time. And a curveball to begin the at-bat, 0-1. Really a good job so far by this guy out of the bullpen.
Yeah, he's come in and really put his stamp on this game. He's thrown a lot of strikes. That's what you want.
Now the 0-1 is swung on and lifted out to straightaway center field. And the catch is made there, two gone here in the ninth.
Well, they took him up the ladder right there with the fastball, and he actually did a pretty good job to get wood on it at all. But it's still an easy play out there in center field.
Chris Davis will try and erase his 0-for-4 in the ballgame. And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1.
And sometimes you got to cut down a little stride against a guy who's throwing this hard. Either you take that leg kick completely out of the equation, or you get it started just a little bit quicker.
And he goes the other way with a fastball as this is hit in the air toward the gap in right center. Craig will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. Gone in order are the Brewers, but no matter, they lead it 8-2. Alan Craig will dig in. He doubled home a run last time around. He'll start him with a sinker here, but that sinks a bit too much that time. It's 1-0. The victory would go to Giovanni Gallardo should the lead hold up here. The 1-0. First two pitches off the mark here. It's 2-0. Not very aggressive there, as that's down the middle for strike one. Just off the inside part of the plate, it's 3-1.
And boy, this is exactly how you want your leadoff hitter to approach an at-bat. He's showing a lot of patience, and it's worked out so far.
And good contact there, as this is hit high and deep to right center. Braun is going to get back, and he'll put this one away on the warning track for the first out.
Now batting, first baseman, Matt Adams.
Matt Adams will stand in. Base on balls his last time. Ball one.
That's the ball.
One out, nobody on. One oh pitch now. 2-0.
I need to see that again, because I agree. It looked like he flat missed that call behind the plate.
Little doubt about that one. That's in there, and it's 2-1. You have to say they've really had a good game plan for attacking the 3-4-5 hitters all game long.
Yeah, and I think the only thing that's better than a game plan has been the execution of that game plan. You're exactly right. They've held this lineup at bay.
Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground towards second. On to first, and they're an out away. Two gone here in the ninth. Cardinals are down to their final out now. And here now is the catcher, Yadier Molina. Now pitch pulled on the ground over to Ramirez at third. On to first, and that is going to conclude the festivities here tonight.
And you know what? I don't care who you're playing. You know, it's never easy to go out on the road and win any game. So that was a great effort by them in every phase of the game.
An entertaining game all in all, so if we have to choose one who stood out among all others, why not go with this man right here? He's our Topps player of the game.
Yeah, I think in the end, this really could have been anybody's award, but what the heck, let's go ahead and give it to this guy. He's as deserving as anybody.
So that'll just about do it. For Eric Harrow, Steve Lyons, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjian. This has been a presentation of MLB The Show. For more, don't forget to check out theshownation.com. The Brewers win it 8-2. Good night from St. Louis.
Score for our ball game tonight for the victorious Brewers. 8 runs, 10 hits, no errors. They left 3 men on base. For St. Louis, 2 runs, 6 hits, 1 error. They left 6.